Alright, folks, so I just wanted to show off my Hitman statue. It's something that I'm really proud to have. It looks great. It's classy. I particularly wanted Rose and Vienna Jordan to see it. I wanted them to know that it's on my desk, and it does remind me about a threat. Just as I'm surfing the internet or chilling out on my desk, I have the Hitman statue there to remind me that he's out there. So this is a Xbox One gift set that comes with the statue, some version of Hitman for Xbox One. I think it's the very first one. And a graphic sort of story guide or instruction booklet. But it's not really like an instruction book that... I don't know. It's not an instructions for the game, but it's more like screenshots and sort of the backstory of different levels and kind of what you go through, what you can expect to go through in the game. So it's kind of interesting. I took the time to, in the book... It's a hardcover, by the way. It's like a tabletop, almost. There is several pages at the beginning and at the end. And so I just went through, like, sort of a diary, basically, and talked about my experiences with, like, the movies, the Hollywood, and what kind of things that I've been through. You know, as a Scientology kid. And I made some notes and remarks and stuff like that. And I sent it to my best friend in Buffalo, New York. His name's Baron Valukas, and we went to high school together. So he's got the game. It's actually a download. So the gift set doesn't come with... the Blu-ray disc. It's like a download code coupon, and you add the game to your account. I thought that was pretty fun to kind of open up Baron's eyes a little bit to kind of what Hitman could be, or, you know, what, as far as the game goes, what, you know, how realistic it could possibly get, because I think a lot of the missions, I think all of the missions are in Europe, if I'm not mistaken. Yeah, I, you know, my take on Xbox One is that the controllers are great, or the Elite controller is great. I tried my brother's Elite controller, and it seems to be a pretty high quality controller. But you know, I decided not to get Xbox One. I don't, first of all, I wouldn't play it nearly enough for it to be worth the money. I'm satisfied with sort of the retro arcade I've put together on the Sony PlayStation 3 and the Nintendo Wii U. Those are excellent consoles. If you're just looking at retro gaming, you know, the stuff that I'm into, as well as whatever is available on the Wii and PS3. I mean, if you're looking for something decent, then you don't have to spend a lot of money. So, my opinion is that Xbox One is kind of a fad, I guess you could say. I'm not a big Madden player either. So, like, I don't own Madden. I own NBA 2K13, and there's a baseball MLB The Show 2010, or I don't even remember what year it is, but those are just for you know, to play like certain teams or whatever year, whatever teams were good that year, then I would just play kind of that type of thing, whatever kind of players I liked from that era, then I would just do that. You know, depending on what I feel like as far as multiplayer goes. Haven't played anything as far as Hitman goes. I haven't played Hitman at all for any system.